Hi there, and thanks for joining us here on the web. Goffstown police say that speed may have been a factor in a deadly crash. Police say one car and two motorcycles crashed on a mountain road last night. One motorcyclist was pronounced dead at the scene. The other was flown to a Boston hospital with life-threatening injuries. Their names are not being released. A Meredith woman has passed away from injuries she suffered in a crash in Sandwich. State police say 45-year-old Sherry Lewis was driving on Route 25 early Sunday morning when her SUV went off the road and rolled over, throwing her and her passenger, 41-year-old Robert Guidi, from the vehicle. Lewis died last night. Guidi suffered serious injuries. Well, a driver involved in a four-vehicle crash on the Spalding Turnpike in Rochester last week has passed away. State police say 34-year-old Karen Fair of Manchester died yesterday morning from her injuries. Police are still investigating that accident. 12 families are homeless this morning after fire tore through their Dover apartment complex yesterday afternoon. Fire officials believe the three-alarm fire started in the breezeway that runs between 5 Western Ave. No one was hurt, but 4 of the 12 units were affected by the fire and were told the other units sustained smoke damage. Some of the families living there lost everything, but they say they're grateful to be alive.
Well, I lost everything, you know, everything. So I had to start all over again, but that's okay too. It's just stuff, just stuff.
That's the most important. She's safe. Everything can be replaced, but her cannot be replaced. So I'm so glad that she's here with us.
The Red Cross is working with the families who were left homeless. The cause of the fire is under investigation. Well, the stage is set in Tampa, Florida for next week's Republican National Convention. And this morning we're learning new details about Senator Kelly Ayotte's speech. A Republican source tells us that Ayotte will speak a week from today, next Tuesday night, on the second day of the convention. She's expected to focus her speech on the importance of small business as the backbone of America's economy. A dedication will be held at Manchester Central High School next month to remember a grad who was killed on 9/11. Kathy Bantis was a 1975 graduate of Central High and was on the 99th floor of the North Tower on 9/11. Her family has been invited for the dedication of a memorial plaque on September 10th. Well, the city of Nashua is being listed as one of the best places to live in America. The list, put out by CNN Money and Fortune magazine, puts the Gate City at number 93, the only community in New Hampshire to make the list. The report points to local jobs being offered by high-tech companies, the state's lack of a sales tax, and proximity to Boston. Here are the top five. Carmel, Indiana took the number one spot, and Newton, Mass was the tops in the region, coming in at number 4. That's it for this morning's webcast. We hope you can join us for more news today at noon. Take care.